Hello everyone, welcome to Lectures by Aparna. Today we will discuss the application of Thevenin's theorem in transistor analysis. So let's consider a voltage divider bias circuit. So this is our circuit. Here in the input side, this input side is a little bit complex network compared to the output side of this circuit. So while we do analysis on this input side, to simplify the analysis we use Thevenin's theorem. So the usual way of simplifying it is to make it like this. So this circuit will be made like this, so that on the input side it will be easier to analyze. So let's see what does the Thevenin's theorem say. Suppose I'm having a network like this. Say I'm having a network like this. Let this be RL, let this be R1, R2, and let this be V. So first step in applying Thevenin's theorem, first step is to remove the load resistance, take away this RL. So now the circuit will look like this is V, this is R1, this is R2. Let this be terminals AB. The second step of Thevenin's theorem is to find the voltage across this VAB. This will be the VTH. That is where the load resistance has been removed. From that terminal, we have to find the voltage across that terminal. So we have to find VTH. The third step is to find RTH or Thevenin's resistance. For that, in this circuit, you have to replace voltage source. If there is a voltage source, that should be replaced by a short circuit. Or if there is a current source, it should be replaced by an open circuit. So here, in this case, it is a voltage source. So I'll replace this V with a short circuit. So the circuit will become like this. Now I have to find the resistance from this side. Effective resistance by looking from this side, that will be the Thevenin's resistance. So what will be RTH here? Here RTH will be this R1 parallel to this R2. R1 parallel to R2. So now we got the value of VTH and RTH. So once you get these values, we can draw the Thevenin equivalent circuit. Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So that will be like this. This VTH that we obtain will be connected here. This is VTH, this is RTH, and then we will connect back the load RL. So this circuit has become this form, and thus the analysis of this circuit will become easier. Now let's come back to our voltage divider bias circuit. We have to apply the Thevenin's theorem here. So the first step is to remove the load resistance. So I am cutting this part, cutting this voltage divider bias circuit in this portion and separating the input side. So now the circuit will look like this. So this is how now the circuit looks like. The input side of this circuit will look like. This is the portion that is going to the base of this transistor, and this one is the one connected to the ground. So these two terminals. Now we have to do the second step. Second step is to find the Thevenin's voltage. Second step is to find the Thevenin's voltage VTH. That will be the voltage across this terminals, VTH. So I'll redraw this circuit as there is a VCC here, then there is this R1, then there is this R2, this is the ground. Let this be, I'll name these terminals as A and B. This is the terminals A and B. That is, we have to measure the voltage across this R2. This is R2. And that voltage will be the Thevenin's voltage. So now here, the voltage across R2 will be the total voltage. I am using voltage division rule here. So the total voltage into the resistance across this is R2 divided by sum of resistances R1 plus R2. So in this case, the value of, here it is given that the value of VCC is 5 into R2 is 1 kilo ohm divided by R1 plus R2 is 1K plus 4K. So this will be 5K by 5K, which will be 1 volt. So VTH, I got it as 1 volt. Now I have to find RTH. RTH. So RTH can be obtained by replacing this voltage source by its internal resistance, or voltage source is replaced by a short circuit. So by looking from this side, I have to find the effective resistance, which is RTH. RTH will be this R1 parallel to R2. This will be R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Which will be the value of R1, it is 4K into R2 is 1K divided by 4K plus 1K, which will be 4000 by 5, or it will be equal to 800 ohm. So I got RTH as 800 ohm. Now I have to draw the Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So making this as Thevenin's equivalent circuit, it will be, there is a VTH, that is 1 volt. This is VTH. Then there is the Thevenin's resistance RTH, which is 800 ohm. Now this terminal, it will be connected to the base of the transistor. So connecting it back to the base of the transistor, this will be RC, this will be VCC. Here there will be RE, and here the ground will be connected. So this circuit became like this. This circuit became like this. This is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit of this circuit. Now you can easily do the analysis on the input side. In this way, Thevenin's theorem can be used in transistor analysis. If this video has helped you, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.